5 सेकेंड, 2 सेकेंड, रेडी। एनी वे प्रिसाइसली दिस एस्पेक्ट आई वुड लाइक टू ब्रिंग टू द नोटिस ऑफ द हाउस फ्रॉम द एक्सप्लेनेशन गिवेन इट वॉज क्वाइट क्लियर दैट द प्रोसेस ऑफ एक्विजिशन ऑफ आर्म्स इज अ वेरी लॉन्ग प्रोसेस एंड देयर आर केसेस वेयर इन द रिप्रेजेंटेटिव ऑफ द नेवी ऑप्टेड फॉर अनदर टाइप ऑफ सबमरीन्स द रिप्रेजेंटेटिव ऑफ द इंडियन नेवी हैड क्वाइट अ जस्टिफिएबल रीजन इन ऑप्टिंग फॉर दैट सबमरीन बिकॉज द HDW सबमरीन बिलोंग टू वन जनरेशन बिहाइंड देन दिस सबमरीन विच इज मोर सुइटेबल टू इंडियन कंडीशंस दिस वॉज द पोजिशन ऑफ द रिप्रेजेंटेटिव फ्रॉम द इंडियन नेवी ही एक्सप्रेस्ड इट इन द मीटिंग इफ द इंफॉर्मेशन विद मी इज करेक्ट इन द थर्ड मीटिंग ऑफ द प्राइस निगोशिएटिंग कमेटी द नेवी मैन वॉज कॉल्ड असाइड and told that he should not insist that this submarine should be more suitable for our country. So this has happened. If this has happened, I expect an explanation from the Honorable Minister as to how this has happened. And if this has happened, anyone can question the suspicion that similar episodes would not have happened whenever the price negotiations are being made. And we know that ultimately the decision will be taken at the highest level. Whatever transpires at the price negotiation committee, the final decision is being taken by the cabinet committee for political affairs. And here comes the political element in the decision. Sir, it is quite natural. I do not want to attribute the responsibility to anyone. But in the Cabinet Committee for Political Affairs, the Prime Minister presides over the meetings and those who are accessible to the Prime Minister can naturally only mention that in the bargain between the various firms, it would be better to select a particular firm. This is where the crux of the matter comes. So, in this background, we do not want to accuse the other side that bona fides cannot be taken seriously. We do not want to say, so we do not want to engage in a competition as to who are more patriotic and who are more concerned about the defense of our country. But to ward off suspicion, to keep up the morale of our defense forces, what we propose is why cannot there be a high power committee including parliamentarians who are knowledgeable in these matters. Fortunately, in this house, we have a few such knowledgeable persons, both from the angle of defense and from the angle of finance and accountancy. Why cannot a high power committee of experts be constituted to scrutinize and decide on the purchases of arms from abroad? Not every purchase, but purchases in which a substantial amount is involved, which can be discussed and decided upon. There is a specific point which we would like to reach, and this will help improve the situation. There need not be any unwarranted suspicion on such matters, and if you cannot believe such a high power committee, we have no other option to believe what you say. Sir, we are not saying that everybody should be allowed to go into all aspects, but defense cannot be kept as a sacred cow that no one can touch. This is very important. Secondly, the overall perspective of our defense. We understand that given the geopolitical situation today, a country like India has to spend money, substantial money, for our defense. We do not understand the necessity of spending for defense because the threat from the American imperialism is no more illusory. Everybody, we are reading reports about how the American imperialism is arming Pakistan with modern equipment and its own personnel to man it. We know how the American imperialism is trying to encircle our country, how the independence of the third world countries is threatened by the American imperialism. We are aware of it. In this situation, it is painful that substantial amount is being taken away for defense purpose, which would have been otherwise utilized for other developmental purposes. That is why I say it is painful, but there is no other option. But at the same time, just by acquiring the modern arms and keeping the army, you cannot defend our country. No one can do so. People should be made aware of the threats coming from imperialism. On this aspect, we are constrained to see that the party at the helm of affairs who rules our country is not doing its duty. You are limiting your criticism of the American imperialism only to statements only when you are catch up in some allegations, only when some skeletons come out of your cupboard, you are woken up to the threat of the imperialism, and the efforts of foreign hands is destabilizing if you fail to educate the masses of our country regarding the threat coming from the imperialism and how the imperialism, especially the American imperialism, is trying to arm Pakistan and encircle our country. The people cannot be mobilized for defense of our country. I may be permitted to remind you the experience of the time of the Second World War in the Soviet Union, when countries after countries were kneeling before the might of Nazi Hitler. It was the Soviet Union which started the defeat of Nazism in the Second World War.